Hare Krishna, welcome for the discussion on Bhagavad Gita chapter number 3. So today we are going to discuss from verses 3 to 9. And today Krishna is going to reply for Arjuna's questions which we saw in the last verse. So now in this video we will see that Lord Krishna will explain Nishkama Karma Yoga in detail and also recommend Arjuna to follow this path of Nishkama Karma Yoga over the other path like Jnana Yoga. So let us start today's verse, verse number 3.
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Lokesmin Vivida Nishta Pura Prokta Mayanaga Jnana Yogena Sankhyanam Karma Yogena Yoginam.
So the meaning of this verse is like this. The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, O sinless Arjuna, I have already explained you that there are two classes of men who try to realize the self. Some of them are inclined to understand it by empirical philosophical speculation and others by devotional service. So here Lord Krishna is explaining that he has already explained that there are two classes of men. That he explained in the previous chapter, chapter 2 in verse number 39, where he told that I have already explained you about Sankhya and now I am going to explain you about Buddhi Yoga. So these are the two classes of men. One is Sankhya Yoga or Jnana Yoga followers and others who follow the path of Buddhi Yoga or Nishkam Karma Yoga. So now Krishna is telling that there are these two classes of people. And these two classes of people have different ways to approach the Supreme Lord or to understand the absolute truth. So one is Jnana Yoga path, where they try to understand by experimental knowledge and philosophical speculation. And it is a little indirect path. And the one more path is the Buddhi Yoga, where Krishna himself tells in verse number 61 in the previous chapter that Yukta Asita Matparaha, this process itself involves that everything, all the senses, mind, everything should be engaged in the service of the Lord, and through that way you control your senses and achieve the Supreme Lord. So this is a bit direct process. So these are the two processes and they are interdependent on each other. About this Krishna is going to explain in more detail in 5th chapter, 5th verse. There we can see in detail. So these are interdependent, just like philosophy and religion. Religion without philosophy is just a sentiment, and philosophy without religion is mental speculation. So more understanding we'll get as we go ahead in the Bhagavad Gita. Now we will see the next verse, verse number 4.
Na karmana manarambhan Naishkarmyam purushoshnute nacha sanyasana deva siddhim samadhi gacchati.
So here Krishna is telling, not by merely abstaining from work can one become free from all kinds of reactions, nor by taking to renunciation only can one achieve perfection. So here Krishna is telling to Arjuna that one cannot attain perfection just by renouncing all kinds of activities or duties or taking to sannyas, the fourth order. That Krishna is not recommending for Arjuna here. And some empirical philosophers, they propagate or think that if one just takes to sannyas or renounced order, retiring from all kinds of activities, then one can become as good as Narayana. But Krishna does not recommend this kind of path. Why Krishna is not recommending Arjuna this? We will see more in the next verse, verse number 5.
Nahi kaschit kshanamapi jyatu tishtyatya karma krit karyate hyavasha karma sarva prakriti jairgunaihi.
Everyone is forced to act helplessly according to the qualities one has acquired by the material modes of the nature. So no one can refrain from working, not even for a moment. Soul by nature is very active. Soul, mind, senses, they are all active. They cannot sit idle or silent. they have to act. So when the soul is present in the body and there are mind and senses, then they are going to act in somewhere the other way. Hence there are prescribed duties mentioned in the shastras so that the soul, the body and the mind and the senses can be positively engaged, through which they can be purified and eventually practice Krishna consciousness and perfect their lives. Now, because everybody has different kinds of nature, as mentioned in this verse, it is acquired because of the effects of different modes of material nature. As we know, there are three modes of material nature. How much a person is affected by which mode, that decides what kind of nature and qualities he possesses. And then accordingly, the prescribed duties are mentioned for him. So when one follows this process, then that is good and ultimately can achieve Krishna consciousness. So now we will see why Krishna is telling like this and how, if the mind is not engaged properly and connected to Krishna, then what it is going to do and how those people are going to act, that he is going to explain in the next verse, verse number 6.
Karmendriyani samyamya yaste manasasmaran indriyartan vimudhatma mityacharasa uchyate.
One who restrains the senses of action and one whose mind dwells on the sense objects, he is deluding himself and he is called as pretender. So there are many pretenders whom you can find. They don't work in Krishna consciousness. They refuse to act in Krishna consciousness. They don't practice the Bhagavad Gita instructions. But they claim themselves to be a great meditators or yogis, and they bluff big philosophy and they cheat innocent people, their followers. Because their mind is always dwelling on sense enjoyment, they cheat and exploit their followers. And whatever they speak has actually no value. So we need to be very careful about these people which Krishna is mentioning in this verse. This is what we learn from this verse. Now what Krishna is going to recommend to Arjuna, we will see in the next verse. Verse number 7.
Yastvindriyani manasa niyamyarabhate arjuna karmendriyai karma yogam asakta savishishyate.
So Krishna tells here, on the other hand, if a sincere person tries to control his active senses by mind and begins karma yoga without attachment, is by far superior. So in this verse, Krishna is comparing with the last category which he mentioned in the previous verse, the false renunciant, and he is telling the person who engages his mind and senses in karma yoga without attachment is by far superior. And he is recommending basically Arjuna that you follow this karma yoga or prescribed duties which are given to you according to your varna and ashrama. As a varna, you are belonging to kshatriya, and an ashrama, you are in grihastha ashrama. So you should follow those prescribed duties. That is better for you than becoming a false renunciant. So now we'll see more in this regard, Krishna speaking in next verse, verse number 8.
Niyatam kuru karmatvam karma jyayo hya karmanaha sharira yatra apichate na prasiddhyedya karmanaha.
So Krishna is telling here, Arjuna, perform your prescribed duty. That is better than not working at all. Because even for maintaining one's own physical body, one needs to work. So here Krishna is advising Arjuna to do his prescribed duties of a kshatriya and a grihastha rather than he become a pretender. So how not to get implicated in the cycle of birth and death or get into the material bondage by doing activities or karma, that Krishna is going to explain in the next verse. Verse number 9.
Yajñārtāt karmaṇon yatra lokoyam karma bandhana tadardam karma kaunteya mukta sangah samāchara.
The meaning of this verse is like this. Yajñārtāt karmaṇo means the work should be done as a sacrifice for Lord Vishnu. Anyatra, otherwise, the work will cause bondage. Lokoyam karma bandhana. So it will cause you bondage in this material world. Tadardam karma kaunteya. So, if you act for the satisfaction of Him, Lord Vishnu, then Mukta Sangha Samachara, then you can be liberated from this bondage. So, basically, everyone has to work for maintaining his body. So, that work has to be done as a sacrifice for Vishnu. That is the aim of even Varnashrama institution or system. Okay, that's why different duties are prescribed. And one needs to basically engage everything in Krishna consciousness or serve for the satisfaction of Krishna. So for this, to do this practice, how to do it, that needs expert guidance in the beginning, and that guidance should be taken from a devotee of Lord Krishna or Lord Krishna himself. Like here, Arjuna is getting the guidance directly from Lord Krishna. And now in the further verses, we will see in the next 7 verses that Krishna is going to explain this about sacrifice and the cycle of sacrifice and how to practice this karma yoga nicely. So that we will see in the next video. Till then, thank you very much for watching. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.